Thank you. Testing, testing, am I live? Looks like it. All right. Just gonna turn that down a little. Welcome back, my lovelies. Whisper219 here, and I'm diving back into Spooky's Jump Scare Mansion. And I'm going to be conquering the DLC today. Pretty sure I can knock both of them out in one stream. They're not super difficult. Compression gloves. All right. So, I have a drink. I have snacks. Every day is Wednesday, don't forget. Nope. Going down. All right, hold on. Move you down there. There we go. Now you can actually see the room number. Not really like it matters, but... You know what, since the room count isn't a big deal, I'm just gonna put my webcam back where it was. Hi. That was a weird noise. Thank you. Someone had a bad time. Do I want to do this? Okay. Clearly you are busy. I will leave you alone. Locked. The woods never forget, so neither should you. Electronically sealed. Okay. Oh, great. What's this way? Break room. Nurse Tanaka, report 404. Seems we're losing patients due to surgical complications much more often than normal. What have the doctors been doing? Half of these procedures seem completely unnecessary. I know the doctors and surgeons are above me, but probably know many things I don't, but this is getting strange. Ah. Seems weird that the break room is downstairs. Like, even for a hospital. Dr. Hamada, oncologist. Seems the other me has been giving him large doses of hallucinogenics. They've worsened the depression and he's now constantly screaming and expressing terror at seemingly random intervals. I've tried using a dialysis machine to remove some of the drugs, but it seems futile. Okay. So I have played this before, but I kind of powered through it, so I didn't really actually bother to take in the details. Something goes here. Oh, like Resident Evil with the crest in the police. Right. Now I have a sword. Right. Dr. Tochigi, hepatologist. I was just informed that the procedure to extract the patient's liver became fatal. I don't know why. Why did we take his liver? There are no donation requests, and he was showing signs of improvement. The surgical staff told me I personally demanded the liver be removed for an emergency transplant, and the worst thing is, I found it. I found his liver. His entire liver, just sitting on my desk. Okay. Got maintenance key. Okay. Nurse Tanaka, 405. I blacked out today while driving to work. One minute I was driving down the road, and then in an instant I was standing outside my car, staring at a dead cat. Must have hit it with my car and felt sorry. The image of the dead cat has constantly unnerved me today. How did I manage to hit it in such a way that to make its body completely twisted around like that? You didn't hit it with your car. Deformity wing. Looks fake. Ah, exit. This is always fun. Now the hospital's on emergency lighting. But the electronic seals are gone, so means I can go over here and hi. I'm gonna do something that's probably stupid, but making sure to save. Oh. No. Okay. Okay. That door stays closed. Dr. Kanagawa, hematologist. The patient did not recover from the blood loss. I feel like there's a monster inside my head and it's pushing me away while it works on something. I woke up in the patient's room standing over him, while an arterial catheter was in the patient, letting him just bleed out onto the floor. Yeah, I'm gonna not sit down. That seems a bad idea in this instance. Oh, good. Power went out, and now the TVs are on. Let's see what's down the stairs here. We're on the other side of that, so isolation room. Well, that's always a good sign. Broken. The feeling I'm going to be dealing with a specimen chase. Take medallion. Nope. And all the body bags are gone. Sorry, I do have a flashing warning at the beginning, in the title of this, sorry, flashing warning, I forgot this was a thing. Okay. That was scary, but not really. 406. Something sinister is beating on the wall of my subconscious, beating like a war drum, motioning me to march down into hell. Yeah, there's something doing it. Acid. So I need to use that on this. That's some strong-ass acid. Probably should have been wearing a mask or something for that, but considering I'm probably a ghost at this point, doesn't really matter. I'm gonna go back and save.
This place is much bigger than I thought it would be. It's very interesting. Well, keep going, recruit, and I'm sure you'll make it out. Maybe.
Hi. Thanks, Spook. When was it? Was it this one? Yeah. Down, down, deeper down. How about you not? Touch. Feels cold. Okay. Oh. How about no? Flashing warning.
Hmm.
then. So basically, Ben the Merchant, but more aggressive. Good to know. Really give you a thigh workout. Go to the isolation ward, which is downstairs. Do-do-do-do-do. That's the morgue. Isolation room. It wasn't me. I swear it wasn't. It may have been my body and my hands, but I know it wasn't me. Oh my. Found out how to stop them. You see, they are in my head and can control me for a time, but if I keep using the radiology machine to dose my head with radiation, then they go away for a while. Demon cow. Good to know. I don't think I ever encountered that one, when I played through this the first time. I think I just ran the maze and never encountered the Minotaur. Nope. So sorry, my little angel. I've tried hating the man that took you from us, but in the end, the only person I can hate is myself. You always liked to scare people, especially when they didn't understand something. I was confounded no one understood your costume, but I guess people don't read Poe anymore, even with the new Price film. That man clearly overreacted to your fireworks, but we can only blame a PTSD sufferer so much. Hi? Okay. I don't have to run the maze. I mean, I knew that I didn't have to run the maze. So, Spooky dressed up as a Grim Reaper in a red hood. Oh! She dressed up as the Mask of the Red Death. Oh! Deformity Wing. Got it. I'm just gonna leave. I'll just be on my way. All right. All right. So that was Karamari Hospital. Let's dive into Spooky's Dollhouse. The air in here is heavy with must and mold. Your lungs seem to struggle as you inhale. Your ability to heal is inhibited in this place. Okay. Spirit has been recorded. Yeah, I don't like that at all. Okay, I'm gonna need a key. Congratulations, GL Labs Associate! You have been volunteered for our Proud Parent Program. You have been given a doll, and your duty is to train the soul entrapped with it. To confine it to the doll, you must keep it in good spirits and give it attention. Ha ha ha! Many of the beta candidates were children when they died, and will likely attach themselves to you without problems. But there may be times when punishment or extraction of spirit energy is necessary. The energy can feel quite replenishing, but please refrain from abuse, as it negatively affects the ghost. In the event of husk rejection or injury, GL Labs is not responsible under any circumstance. Hi. It's locked from the other side, okay. Oh. Hi. I was a good girl all day long, but when Dad got home, he was all wrong, so I hid in my room until he was gone. And then I shot him in the face at 5:45. His gun was so shiny, sparkly, and neat, and his face was so mushy, gushy, squishy. I wanted to shoot more people, but my mom made me sleepy. Now I'm in this weird house with all these weird white coat people, and they won't give me a gun. Yeah, that's not... Yeah. Locked. Okay, so I need a key to open that. Out of tune. West Wing key. Oh, hi. We've made progress, but none of it has been ideal. We developed a system to summon and contain these spirits. However, we've yet to find a suitable container. When the director first summoned his daughter back from the dead, we were astonished, but she didn't stay here long. Without something proper to tether the spirits back to the earth, they simply fade away. We tried simple jars, phases, and the like at first, but these containers limited the functions of the spirits. We've had minor success using humanoid vessels, but the spirits are still tied to the physical damage of the containers, and thus are too fragile. Maybe you build the dolls out of something more robust? I don't know. Clock room. So... Gotta go... Beds. Hi. Oh. Why don't I just... don't. It's in here again? Oh, right. Tea room for proud parent volunteers. Instruction manual. This room functions to relieve stress and replenish spirit energy in the event that the doll has lost potency. You may use this function by placing the doll upon the pedestal and sitting across from it. In the event of husk projection or injury, GL Labs is not responsible under any circumstance. Good luck, proud parent! I don't know what this fucking voice is, but I'm gonna continue doing it. Yeah, you heal by shaking the doll, and that meter right there shows how much energy the doll has. Actually, I'm gonna set you back down. Go out here and yeah, just shush. We're having difficulty containing one of the stronger spirits. The dolls that we use to hold them keep stretching out and breaking, and then we have to summon the spirit all over again. Theoretically, the size of this vessel shouldn't matter, but it complains that it's all too small. So for now, it's locked up behind an emergency containment door. Save. Tightly in barbed wire. Try to open it? No. Yeah, I have an axe. I don't know why I can't just use that, but... Why does it look like Anna from Frozen? Thank you. No, that's gruesome. What's the purpose of this room? I need the doll for that. I don't fit in this. I can't stretch or else I break. They did this to me. So that's why I saved. Your soul jiggles in endless torment. Shot. You can take him down if you hit him 10 times in the head, but it requires timing. last time I had to deal with that character by the name of Wormy Charles. I leave, he leaves. There might be more advantageous positions to engage him from. Yes. Stay down. Now, because I can no longer hear Charles, I no longer have to deal with him.
Oh hey, there you are. I was wondering where you were. I had forgotten about this place. So many tortured souls are here. Well, anyway, I'm gonna go check on something. See you later.
This is a very weirdly laid out place. Right. And what did Clicky say? 5:45? There we go. At the bolt cutters. Don't know why there wasn't any sound for that, but. So now. Yeah. Is the bolt cutters? Yes. My dear Monica, though it was difficult, I've respected your wishes and let you rest. I miss you every day. I miss you. So much. I'm still going to try and save our daughter. I know it's not what you wanted, but I've already gone too far. She's so close. I just have to find a way to keep her here. I love you. The heck? The artwork in this place is really weird. Oh. Okay. Keep the dolls happy, we created this party room. We even summoned a spirit to entertain them, but this experiment has failed miserably. The dolls hate it here and seem totally freaked out around the clown. I requested the document on how it was found, and apparently they tried to summon a happy human ghost, but instead got something else. It looks human and it acts human, but just to be safe, we installed a cage. Just what did they summon? A demon. You summoned a demon. I haven't told anyone yet, but I think this place is haunted. There are like these strange woaning sounds all the time. Like a moan, but also like, whoa, you know? So, woaning. And there's this painting that I kept staring at, and I think it was changing. Yes, this painting. It does actually change if you stare at it long enough, but I'm going to. It changes very slowly. Ah. Don't have what the furnace needs, so that's not it. Guessing it's in here. Yep. Is it? Right. Well, that's not intimidating at all. A doll is a timeless thing, in the shape of a human, but created perfect. Immortal and unmoving, yet hollow, devoid of soul. Fitting symbol and possibly usable device for our goals here. Soon I will have you back, my dear, but first I must make sure I won't constrict you. Right. Oh, yeah. Hate that. Hate that. Several broken doll parts and a pair of plastic clasped hands that appear to be holding something. They are slightly melted together. Pick it up? Yes. Have to use the furnace to melt plastic doll hands in. Yes. Close the furnace. Furnace. Doll hands have melted away, revealing a small key. Pick it up? Yes. Ow, ow, what? Like how there's just a room labeled clown. All right. I've unlocked GL Labs. What's this room? All our research and experimentation, we were looking in the wrong place. The dolls did a little bit to distract us. They could not fill my heart, and they were not suitable for you to inhabit. That's why you did not come back to me. But now I've found something else, a relic from the old kingdom era that seals spirits to the earth. Though it originally was used for great evil, I will use it for you. Hmm. That may have been a mistake. Hi. Express yourself. Hopefully now that the doll project over, I'll get transferred back to the surface facility soon. It's been very interesting, but I generally fear for my life every day. That's not ideal job security. Yeah, no, it isn't. Live, laugh, love. Ugh. We abandoned the doll idea of tethering the subject to a physical object, and instead we sealed her spirit within the mansion itself. Her abilities within the facility should be incredible. The director would have been pleased with the outcome of his sacrifice. Nope, that's not it. Access card required. Okay.